West Siberian Laika. The West Siberian Laika, or WSL, is a breed of hunting dog and a breed of spitz type. Russian publications indicate that the term West Siberian Laika loosely applied to hunting dogs originating with the Mansi and Khanty people in Ural and West Siberia, but there were no standards or registrations of WSL as such until 1930. Then WWll disrupted it for a while, but systematic breeding with registrations resumed after the war ended, in 1946. This was the time the breed began taking modern shape. Before that, hunters only knew of Mansi Laika and Khanty Laika. In early 1960, many hunters in Ural still preferred the term Mansi Laika when speaking of West Siberian Laika. In Russian language, the term Laika originated from the word layat that means to bark. The word Laika simply means barker. Any hunting Laika is a bark pointer, pointing at animal of interest by barking and staying with the animal. It is a versatile dog depending on use and environment, but in certain parts of the country they have become more specialized. Origins. Laikas, occurring on Russian territory, belong to northern primitive breeds retaining traits of their wild ancestor, the wolf, in the appearance and behavior. They are dogs with pointed muzzle, slightly rangy or nearly square body, and often gray or gray mixed with red, like in the wolf coat color predominate. They are small to medium-sized pariah-type dogs that originally accompanied humans since prehistory worldwide, until they became replaced with lop-eared, specialized for certain style of hunting, cultured breeds. In large sparse or populated parts of Russia, this process came at a later time, and aboriginal Laika types still remain with hunters in remote northern and northeastern provinces of the country. History. Deforestation of land for agriculture and industrialization in later 19th early 20th centuries accelerated replacement of Laikas with other popular at the time dogs. Russian experts of the late 19th century distinguished dozens of varieties of aboriginal Laikas, each associated with a particular ethnic group of indigenous people of northeastern Europe and Siberia, but none of them had been considered as purebred and pedigreed. Russians tried to save some hunting Laikas from extinction by bringing them from different provincial parts of Russia in cities of European part of the country and breeding them pure. Starting from 30th and especially after World War II, they established four breeds as purebreds: the Carolo-Finnish Laika, the Rus-European Laika, the West Siberian Laika, and the East Siberian Laika. They are bark-pointing dogs and their hunting behavior is generally similar. All of them are descendants of aboriginal types of Laikas selectively sampled from large territories and lumped into the four breeds for breeding in kennels. Among all of them, the West Siberian Laika became most popular, and by present time it is most numerous Laika far beyond its original range in Russia. Appearance. The West Siberian Laika is a medium to large-sized dog. Males are 22 to 24 inches and females are 20 to 23 inches at the shoulder. Reproduction. The majority of females of the West Siberian Laika have one estrus per year, usually in February and March. Some females have their first estrus not fixed by a certain season. The first estrus can be at age of 1 to 2.5 years. Russian experts do not recommend breeding Laikas until they are at least 2 years old. The number of puppies per litter varies from 1 to 9, but litters of 3 to 7 puppies are most frequent. Females of the West Siberian Laika are good mothers and, if conditions permit, dig their own whelping dens, give birth to puppies and raise them without any assistance as soon as the food is available. Character and behavior. The West Siberian Laika is a very affectionate and devoted to the master dog. The majority of them bark at strangers approaching the house. Their attitude to unfamiliar people varies individually and depending on the situation. Some dogs first bark and then wag their tails, greeting the guest and allow themselves to be petted. Many West Siberian Laikas are aloof with a strange person, avoid hands and watch him suspiciously. Some dogs become protective of the master, his family and their property. Many West Siberian Laikas accept a new owner with difficulty and need time to adjust to a new place. According to standard, aggressiveness to unfamiliar people is not typical. West Siberian Laika is highly territorial and may be aggressive to other intruding dogs of the same sex. Adult Laikas, especially males, should only hunt with dogs raised in the same household. West Siberian Laika can easily learn to leave alone farm animals and are naturally capable of telling apart wild game from domesticated animals. Cats of the same household are accepted, but stray cats will be treated like game. Utilitarian qualities. The West Siberian Laika is primarily a hunting dog. Anyone who decides on a puppy of this breed should expect a full package of traits of a typical hunting spitz. It is an emotional dog, very observant to the habits of its master, his mood and often can foresee his intentions. It does not hesitate to express its strong feelings by barking and other noises. The West Siberian Laika is a poor kennel dog. If the dog is left alone, locked up in a small backyard or in a pen, some dogs develop a habit of barking, seemingly without a purpose. Permanently penned or fenced West Siberian Laikas attempt to dig under the fence or climb over it. Some dogs not trained to stay penned try to bite the wires and thereby they damage their teeth. Once freed or turned loose, such a dog will be hard to control. It will run too far, chase other animals and likely get into trouble. West Siberian Laikas that are kept well exercised, busy with hunting and contacts with other dogs, animals and people, are content, obedient and never bark without a reason. Therefore, to make a happy dog and its owner, the right conditions of the environment for hunting plus time dedicated to the dog must be met. All West Siberian Laikas are naturally protective against wild animals, especially predators, and some dogs are protective against strangers acting suspicious or violent. A West Siberian Laika will make a good companion dog for a hiking trip. However, its extraordinary interest in wildlife demands special attention because the dog may tree some animals and stay far behind for some time. The West Siberian Laika is a great psychotherapy dog for able-bodied active people, who are not lazy to walk a lot and hunt. He needs regular free exercising between hunting seasons. Take him for walking trips in safe places often and stay healthy. If you have bears in the woods near you, this dog would be the best to warn you or your loved ones in time about the bear's presence and may even show you a tree bear. If a Laika sees a bear, they will run toward the bear, not from it, and they will be barking. When a Laika barks at a bear, their voice sounds as if they were barking at a human, very unlike when they are barking at a squirrel. Treeing squirrels and other small game comes naturally. Just take your puppy in woods and turn him loose. He will start finding his own squirrels by age of 4 to 10 months. Mansi, Khanty, Russians and any other ethnic groups of people living in Russia use the same dogs for hunting and as alarm dogs. Some West Siberian Laikas work well herding reindeer herds. During any activity or training, hunting overrules everything else. A Mansi never minds if his Laika abandons his reindeer herd for a while, especially if his Laika finds valuable game. Mansi and Khanty use reindeer and, in some cases, horses as a draft animal, but good hunting dogs are never used to pull sleds. It would be like using a valuable dagger to chop firewood. If a sled dog is needed, they use another kind sturdy built and larger dog called in Russian Yezdovaya Laika or Sled Laika. This is practiced mainly in polar tundra where reindeer have nothing to eat.